What is up, everybody? Invite back to the Crypto Rush, your home for your crypto fix. I'm your host, Wave Van Winkle. Ideally, everybody's having an astounding day. It is Wednesday. It's November 8th, as bullish November keeps driving us as far as possible into the new year and into another bull run cycle. I really want to believe that you are prepared, people. Since this present time presently is the opportunity your collection ought to be in progress, this present time is the opportunity you ought to have. E-leave procedure set up this moment is the opportunity you ought to have your affairs in order. It is that basic. Don't stand by on the grounds that in a flash it will be too lengthy. We will be into full bull mode. The main thing which I can suggest is that you ought to be on your number one trade. You ought to demand your withdrawals to be up. A ton of these trades keep you at an extremely low, least like 10,000 per day. You ought to be expanding that, people. You ought to be seeing six figures each day. It's that straightforward. Beginning the interaction now before these trades get hindered. In this video, we got a ton to go over. As you most likely are aware, Wave Grow, it's on the manner in which we got some significant news, like continuously emerging from enlarge. The main thing, we'll check whether XRP can hold this 66 penny district, or is it 68? It's close to there. We'll call it 66 to 68 pennies. We retested it yesterday. We bobbed off wonderfully. We returned up to that 70 penny mark. We should see Eck whether we get another retest before we move back up, and before we focus on that 80 penny locale, then we begin discussing a dollar XRP. We will discuss the Bitcoin design that is as of now working out and give you the potential gain and the disadvantage of the ongoing targets we could be. We will give you a XLM target you ought to be focusing on for this bull run. We will talk HSBC in a significant declaration, since this is huge, and yes, to be sure, it includes Wave and XRP. We will discuss home loans, and afterward the complete digital currency market cap, where we are anticipating that XRP should go during this bull cycle. So moving along, we should hop into this. On a side note, I assume I got all my volume issues sorted out. Whether or not the volume sounds better, let me know underneath. People, Bitcoin, it's up 1.74%, coming in at $35,398. Ethereum right behind, it's up 0.25%, coming in at $18.84. USDTA and USDC both coming in at their dollar stakes, as XRP is buy. And by the number 4 cryptographic money market cap out there hopping, Binance Coin, it's up 1.34%, coming in at a mean lean 69 pennies. It needs to return to that 70 penny locale. Now, I put out the XRP graph 7 days prior. I let you know XRP will magically transport up to that 70 to 72 penny range, and very much like the diagram said, precisely exact thing we did, very much like the outline said, we had a hold we kept yesterday and we skipped down up. It's that straightforward. Right now, 70 to 72 pennies, we want to see a cutting edge. We would rather not. We traverse 70 and 72 tie on, and on the grounds that we're getting to the following significant areas of obstruction, which stay in the area of 82 to 88 pennies, it will be an undeniable irritation to get through. Yet I believe we will do it with conviction. Complete digital currency market cap 1,341,000,000,000. We are still far off from the bygone era high. Yet that will get broken, that will get obliterated. Recall, Bitcoin truly hasn't moved. Presently, we've been drifting around this reach for Bitcoin 35,0370. We really want to get over that 40 to 420 territory so Bitcoin can join the party, and it will recollect Bitcoin will be the main mover. It's that straightforward. John Deaton put this out. He goes, despite the fact that I accept a spot Bitcoin ETF ought to have been endorsed quite some time in the past, I accept the planning of a spot ETF endorsement will assist with making the powerful coincidence for Bitcoin what Wall Road needs Wall Road typically gets. And I will add, stress that, well, Wall Road needs Wall Road gets. It's that basic. And think about what Wall Road needs from the Fed. You realize you took care of business. We as a whole realize, regardless of the situation and the imminent future rate cuts and the cash printing will happen, joined with rate cuts, expanded liquidity, Bitcoin's having an 8 to 10 spot ETF endorsements, and max KAIS is $220 Bitcoin value. Not maybe so insane. Year and a half from now, I will step down, say 220 is a little minimal. Fantastical, I believe we're truly going to see 120, 140 for Bitcoin, some in the middle between those lines. Yet I've been teaching this on this channel for a long while. The Bitcoin ETF, the institutional cash, it is the thing will drive the bull run, the bull cycle. This time around, we will get institutional cash entering. Think about how high the establishments can bring digital money. The regular person took this market cap to 2 7 trillion. Think about the organizations hopping in and all the new cash they will be onboarding in addition to their cash that they are all going to bring the digital money markets. How high we can go, 4 to 7 trillion, that is my perfect balance. Yet we have seen the explanatory pass over PAP, assuming that we get that wall road cash, assuming we see them beginning to cycle 2 or 3 several bucks from the conventional 401k. 457s, and saying how about you go somewhat dangerous and bounce into these digital currency markets with, you know, a 5% designation, perhaps as high as 10, relying upon your age and hazard level. We can see the all-out digital money market cap taking off to 17 trillion bucks this cycle bull. Graphs don't lie, it's simply all the question of when do we arrive. We told you crypto would have been greater than the website time website period was over 10 trillion. We will arrive. Question is, does it happen this cycle? Does it occur next cycle? I solidly accept in the event that the foundations are hopping into digital money this cycle, this might actually be the last significant bull run that we have seen. Organizations won't hop in only for a half year of fervor and afterward get out, and afterward stand by 3.5 years to get back, and they will get and they will embrace the innovation, and these business sectors will carry on like ordinary business sectors. Focus on that departure. Crypto. Put this out, the Bitcoin design, he goes, it's a respective example. You got two decisions here. Bitcoin, you even take your action out of this 35,000 territory, you go up to 38k. Or on the other hand, you will return, and you will return to 31,000 bucks. Here you go, we're searching for the breakout here, close to 35,500. Assuming we get the breakout, we will go up to that 38,000 locale, which will put us at my objectives of 40 to 42k. Assuming we bomb the breakout, and we drop out underneath this triangle, we can see a pullback the entire way to that 31,000 district. What's the significance here? Until the end of the business sectors, it will drag it down with it. That is another expo. A nation that we want institutional cash to get in on the grounds that they will keep these gigantic sell enormous drops from happening. Departure crypto XLM target. We haven't discussed XLM in a long while, yet I believe you will like the graph that he's setting up there. Here's where we are, 12 penny XRP, 11 penny XRP, or XLM, excuse me, heavenly, can be searching for a push up this bull cycle as far as possible up to that 1.618 Fibonacci level. Anybody who documents lies, the 1.618 is an extremely essential level alongside this 0.786. Your sweet zone is here for XLM, 31 to 47 pennies, assuming that gets broken, which I'd solidly expect it will. We could be taking a gander at more than a $3 XLM plate cycle, which would be totally superb. XLM is modest. I might have to build my week by week purchase on XLM driving or pushing ahead to situate myself. I couldn't want anything more than to auction my outs in general. Furthermore, truly keep a larger part of my XRP pushing ahead. However, I really want to ensure that tier is situated enough that to get out he can get out and not lament any of his choices. We get this recall, swells coming, and this is some huge news coming from Expand Everybody. HSBC Day affirms plans to send off advanced resource care in 2024, that is 2 months away, and we're into 2024. They are cooperating with Matako, whose Matako Well Wave possesses. Matako, they're an institutional authority supplier. Swell just bought them. Here's the public statement. Swell procured them back in May of this current year for 250 million bucks. This wave takes an institutional crypto guardianship market expected to arrive at 10 trillion bucks by 2030, and they just bought the Swiss-based Sue. Supplier of computerized resources and care tokenization known as Mateo. Their clients can take care of their home loan bills and advances in XRP, SHIB, and Doge. Fascinating, right? So clients are qualified to cover contract bills and credits and different